class, so we are ready for our grammar class for today. So lately, last class I had started with your chapter 6, that was on preposition, and I had completed the two kinds of preposition already. I had said about preposition of place and preposition of time, and today the third one that we'll be doing is preposition of direction. So what is preposition of direction? It denotes and gives the answer to where. Some preposition of direction, or you can also say movement, are, for example, to, at, towards, through, into, over, under, up, down, and etc. etc. When you say, for example, the boys climbed over the orchard wall to pluck fruit, so you are telling the preposition, and you are telling the preposition of movement or the direction as the sentence requires. When you say Raghu walked under the bridge here, you are saying something about the movement of Raghu. So now, when we are talking about some of the prepositions of movement or direction, so we are going to know its use also. Like, for example, some very used prepositions of movement are, for first one I am talking about is to. And its use is, to is denotes a fixed destination. So when you say we went to the market, means it means to the market, nowhere else. Okay? And when you say I went to school on Sunday, it means you went to school, in a particular place that was your destination. Now coming on to the second important kind of movement of preposition, into. It suggests movement from outside to an enclosed space. Like when you say the children jumped into the pool, or the ball fell into the well, so you are saying that something about the movement from outside to an enclosed area. Then coming on to the third kind, it's towards, and towards denotes movement and is indefinite. Indefinite in the sense when you say walk towards the school and I meet you on the way. So here you means indefinite, means the movement can be taken by any other road or the one road you have suggested. So it's called as indefinite. So now coming on to the next kind, that is upon. When you say upon, it denotes towards. Like the children jumped upon their father when he came home. Means they jumped, they went towards their father. So you use the word, you use the preposition upon. Then off. Off here means away from. Like the fat man fell off his chair. So something about the moment you are talking, that's fell off. Now coming to the prepositions of cause, purpose, or source. So here, it depending on how it is used, it can be a preposition can suggest cause or purpose. So the use in the sentence will say you how it is being used. Has it been used as a cause, or has it been used as a purpose? So some examples of such prepositions are for, of, with, by, from, etc. etc. More you have. So this is just the place for a picnic. So you are saying it's a purpose that you are telling about. He suffered from fever for 5 days. So here it's the cause that you're referring to. So here you have two prepositions given here in your book that say something about its use. The first one being given as by. By is used in the passive to talk to the doer of an action, and mostly every time it's being used in a passive voice. So when you say the thief was beaten by the residents with sticks, so here, the sentence is in the passive voice, and here, hence, by has been used to talk about the doer of an action. When you're talking about with, the next preposition, with denotes who, what the agent of an action is. Like the walls were drilled by the electrician with an electric drill. So here you are talking about the agent, means you are talking about the electrician and the action that is going upon or doing. That is, he is working with an electric drill. Mm. So this is all to talk about the chapter on prepositions. Hope, children, you have understood. And rest the exercises I'll be giving you on and on as I complete with the syllabus. So I'm sure that you are copying down the board work in your notebook also. Be sure that you copy down all your class works that I have been doing in the class, in your notebooks also, in your grammar book, grammar copy, so that anytime you can be asked for your checking purpose and also for your class assessment. So don't delay, and now and then, however I'm doing the class, just have it completed. Okay, students? So this is all from me for today. So have a nice day. Goodbye. Stay well. Stay safe.